We are in. Why is this being weird? Never mind, we're still in.
Hey everybody! Welcome to one more session of D&D Session 6. Oh, we left out in the cliffhanger last time. Which was so great. Right, last time, you guys interrogated a guy that was not a very good interrogation, to be honest.
He was annoying me!
Until it got to a point that he was killed by a warhammer to the chest, separating him into three parts: legs, arms, and head, and pancake.
Why is this being weird?
You guys fought. Oh, you guys didn't fight. You guys went around to the camp, which after a few planning and ins and outs, you actually went into the camp and somebody stabbed someone in the eye.
Hey, Papa.
I'm not mentioning names. Which alerted the camp, and some spider went around on top of a tent and wrapped the rest of the people around. You guys got captured.
Speak for yourself.
Yeah. I was just getting that. You guys got captured, but as sneaky as the tiny gnome is, he managed to get away. And whenever you guys were chained up to the poles, the tiny gnome went back in and charmed a cultist.
We were tied to poles? I thought we were just shackled.
Yeah, you're shackled to a pole. Uh-oh. That's why in the middle, while you're outside. Smog did charm one of the cultists, and he was standing watching while Lady Frolam interrogated Yogg, which transformed about 1,000 times and tried to run away.
Egg.
Sorry, he's down as Yogg. He's down as Yogg again.
Is he?
Oh yeah, he is.
He is.
My character sheet has egg. I don't know why it won't change it.
Wait, your character sheet also has. What the hell's this? Oh,
some secrets.
No. It wasn't a secret actually.
Oh, not secrets.
His image when I see it from the right hand side looks completely
Wait.
Different.
Oh, it is off.
Harder to see.
Yeah, like when you see it from afar, it kind of looks like a nun.
What?
You can see like two white parts, which looks like the weak band on the head, and then not under the chin.
Right. Okay.
Might be me that I'm going insane. Anyways.
Well.
Transformed a couple of times, trying to run away, but Roland didn't let him, and she interrogated Gulad and gathered some information out of him.
Oh, she hypnotized me.
Well, she did something to you. I don't know what, but she did something to you. And she went satisfied, she went back into her tent. And that's where we are back, as everybody has awoken. And this half-elf figure is in between Gulad and Zarian, and he's completely bruised. Like, the poor fella is just mangled. And he's just head slumped down, and he's just standing there. You can see he's looks like he's kind of lost the will to live, actually.
Where did your woman go?
Back into the tent.
Oh, right, okay. Okay.
I guess you must be Leosin.
He doesn't answer. I'm kind of not sure if he's actually conscious or not.
That's a great start.
The guy next to you, Smog, turns to you and says, "Well, show's over, so I gotta get back to work before somebody tells me or kills me or something."
Yep.
As he
wait.
Friend.
Before you go, quick question.
Yes.
Where are the you know, like everything them guys had, you know, like their armor and weapons and that sort of stuff. Where have they been put?
How would I know?
Oh.
I've been just keeping track of the prisoners. Might as well check on that tent over there.
What tent?
He
that one?
There.
Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you.
You can see outside there's an anvil and a few leather working tools and all that.
Okay. Cheers. I would like wave to the guys and go like that way in there.
How? Yes, not how. I was gonna say what's the range of your spell.
What spell?
The one you cast last time.
30 feet.
Charm person.
30 feet.
My thing went weird for a second.
Well, it lasts for an hour.
Yeah, but that wouldn't be an hour.
No, I'm just reading through it, no.
No, it wouldn't be an hour.
Yeah, he's still... No, just seeing if it breaks whenever he's too far away from you, but no, it doesn't.
Yeah, that's
stay,
okay.
So I'd assume not.
That's fine.
It stays for the hour.
Okay.
Right, so here we are. You were saying, sorry? While Smog walks over. I think Zion went unconscious as well.
No, I think. No, I just said the one thing to the guy and he didn't respond.
So are we. There's a post. Are we like behind it with our hands in front? Or are our hands behind us? Is it rope? Is it a shackle?
Let me see if I have a handout that I can show you. I might have one.
Damn it, Nightbot.
Damn it, Nightbot.
Sorry.
Wait, is there no handout for this? Oh, there is. Aha. Shadow players. Shadow everyone. There you go.
What's
that's
that?
The
oh.
pose that you can see.
Oh.
And that's the half-elf. Ignore the mass of cultists and kobolds around them.
It's only an X. What's the worst?
Jeez. That's pretty brutal. That's a lot more intense than I thought it was.
Yeah, that's a pretty, pretty OTT cross thing. Wow.
So yeah, there's five of those there.
And we're like 5-10 feet apart. We can't kick each other. Are feet shackled too?
No, it's just your hands. But yeah, you'd be able to kick each other. If that's what you want to do, yes.
I would just lightly nudge it, with my just kick him a little bit. I don't want to hurt him, just see if he's
like,
even alive.
I'd say your hands are about maybe 2 feet apart. Like, the pole
well, so
is.
I can hold him? Wait, can I hold hands?
No, you can't hold hands. It's like the end of the pole. It's like 2 feet from the end of the pole of the next person, except for Egg that's on a cage.
Well, I just wanted to kick him a little bit, like
yes,
I said, just
you can kick him.
Anything?
Just leave me alone. Stop torturing me.
Torture? We're tied up too.
Hang on, you're charmed. You don't know what you're doing.
What? You said
I just remembered your charm.
That's what I'm saying, you're like, oh, you don't know what's wrong with you. It's like, fine, I'll just stand there in a stupor.
I will nudge the guy over not to burn.
He will heal that sound? Just don't torture me anymore.
We're not torturing you. We're in the same place you are, for Pete's sake.
He lifts his head, he looks around and sees there's you guys next to him. What? How? When did you guys get here? Oh, I must have passed out the ages.
Ow.
So, someone decided to entangle us into a tent when they were getting away and failed miserably. So, about earlier today?
Oh, I heard some ruckus and the alarm going on yesterday. Was that all of you?
Yeah, just a bit.
What are you doing around there, Smog?
Just looking.
He's looking for a snake.
You're looking?
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm just trying to find things.
What are you trying to find exactly?
He doesn't know yet. He's unsure.
He's unsure of what he wants to find.
Okay. Also lost my handbooks. Never mind. Found.
You're also really far from Moondancer.
Where is she? Oh, she's there.
Yeah, she was really far away from you.
Well, I see that we both have a slight predicament. Slight.
Do you guys have any way of escaping?
Well, the one over there can turn into things, but he kind of used them all while trying to aggravate.
He looks over and he looks at Golan, and Golan just like.
No, not that one. That one's a bit special.
How long does this last?
An hour.
6 weeks.
The one in the bigger cage.
Oh, you mean the turtle?
Yes. I think he's some type of a druid.
Oh.
Yeah, that type of person.
Is it? History is intelligence, isn't it?
Yes.
He has no idea. Well, he must be a druid. He's a turtle, so.
No, that's just how he is. He turns
really?
Into other things. Yes.
I've never seen such a thing.
No, apparently they're actually from a place called Chult. Everything I've heard about that place, you never want to go there. Yes, they got mosquitoes the size of your hand.
Holy hell.
It's basically around there.
Well, now I just... You guys need to get out of here before Prolam executes all of you.
But yeah, that would be advised.
Why are you guys here even?
I was sent to rescue you, but...
Wait, really? Who's... Okay.
I forget his name. Hold on. Let me look at my notepad.
How would you have your notepad there?
It's on my foot. Nisum sent us. Some of the others.
The wise one. He was always a reckless one.
Yeah, he's kind of injured right now, so we couldn't come. We told him to stay anyways. Well, I told him to stay anyways.
You must leave this place then. You're just standing there looking at all of them, Smog.
He's looking up this direction.
Oh, right.
Just making notes.
Okay. They're just...
Completely ignoring the gnome.
They're just working away. I can see the other cultists kind of taking the prisoners and all that.
Okay.
But you see, the problem with getting away right now is a bit chained up.
Well, there is
also,
a way.
Also, the bunker's over there. Well, I was thinking of that's when we're about to get executed or something around that lines. Offer to fight for my freedom, to work for them, something along those lines.
Well, I do suggest you guys run away during the night. It's far easier.
Yeah, just a bit.
Well, to be honest, there is another way for you guys to run away. I kinda have the key to the shackles in my boot.
I totally didn't hear that, but okay.
You actually didn't hear it?
No, I heard it.
Oh.
Are our legs free-reined, or...?
Yes, they are.
Okay.
It's just the hands that are shackled.
Yeah. So, by the way, have you noticed when the...
Give me a stealth check, Smog.
I was actually looking and trying to find one for Moondancer, but her character sheet's all weird.
Oh, it probably is because of the update.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Do the big guys only go to bed?
Ba 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 ba. Pop. Be nice. Stop!
These rolls.
So I'm not exactly too worried about the dogs noticing us moving around.
No, the dogs don't seem to.
I just see Smog run past me. I don't know.
Hey! You!
Hey!
Come here!
You're far away.
He turns to the other guys. Did you guys just saw that gnome walking around?
The other guy's like, yeah, whatever.
Just go and find him. Start running towards the tents. He's seen you going towards the tents.
I'm in the tent.
He knows playing, you're there.
He's playing hide and go seek.
What are you doing here?
Hi! Are you George?
You a question.
You George?
What do you mean I'm George?
I don't know, I've been sent here to find George.
Who sent you here to find George?
Your man at the front, at the entrance.
Give me a deception check.
Oh, hell.
George. Where is George?
Be nice. Oh, what?
fuck, I forgot. Is that wisdom?
George.
No, it would be insight.
Yeah, it is wisdom.
Yeah, wisdom.
Oh, there's no George here. Go back to the entrance and tell him George's not here.
Oh, okay.
George went off hunting.
Okay. Wait, I thought George was... Okay, never mind.
Back this way. You were saying something?
No, I'm just trying to, I was just trying to think of how to... Oh no, I was asking him, when the big guys normally went to bed.
Well, some of them go to bed during the night, but they tend to stay around. At least two of them stand there, and the dogs, dragon dogs.
I'm not too worried about the dogs. Well, a little bit worried about the dogs.
If you're gonna do something, I'd suggest you do it during the night.
Early, yes. Do they switch? Do the two just stay there, or do they like switch out with other people?
As far as I've seen, the only they switch, but there's always somebody guarding the tent.
Well, that's gonna be a fun one.
Investigation check. Smog.
Oh.
Smog. Ooh, you do find your friend's weapons in that tent. It seems like they're all there.
Good. Just can't.
He's too small to carry everything.
You can't do damn all about.
You probably can't even carry Gulad's warhammer.
Yeah, it's not that heavy. I think it's like 6 pounds. 88. Only like a third of his body, or yeah, a third of his body weight.
But it's probably the same size as Smog. Well, if you're gonna do something, it has to be during the night.
Oh, yeah, right, totally.
That's the hide of the tent, by the way.
That's the hide in the tent?
Yes, the hide in the tent.
Yeah, you can easily, like, pile both the Zarian's and Golad's shields in front of you and you can hide in there.
That sounds good.
Hide behind them. As soon as you lift, there's not a lot of people around there. There's a lot less people over here than there was down in the first layer. So you guys...
After the big and egg still are probably our best way to do things, but he has to not get noticed when he does things.
I'll give you some time to figure out the plan before we go into before we go into fast time.
Yeah.
Fast forward.
Okay. I guess we're just doing a chain line of whispers.
Chinese whispers.
We're playing
we have the equivalent of a 3-year-old between me and anybody else.
I'll be back.
The Zarian's basically like, okay, Egg can switch into something, get the key and unlock people, but we need to find some way to scout first. So we know if we have equipment here or if it's somewhere else. I'm guessing I can't see the cave behind me, or can I turn my head and see?
No, you wouldn't be able to see the cave behind you, no.
Okay. So we're like trying to figure out like the best way to get out, which is basically no way.
Ryosin would have told you that the best time to get out it is in the middle of the night when most of the camp, if not all the camp, is asleep.
Yeah.
And the best choice it is to run out of the to get out of the camp.
What time is it now, roughly?
It is about 8 o'clock at night.
So it would be starting to get dark.
It's starting to get dark.
Is the sun still out, or is it completely dark?
It's that weird time that it's not dark and it's not day anymore.
Wait, what season is it?
Can I see the sun and the moon at the same time?
No, because there's some hills around you. Like, it is getting dark here, really dark.
So the, we're hopefully, if we're lucky, it will be a, what's it called? Full moon, the other thing.
Total eclipse?
New moon?
Total eclipse.
Total eclipse of the heart, yes. hopefully it will be a new moon tonight. I guess we'll find out.
Wouldn't matter that much, there's still light at night in the camp.
But if we get far enough away, it'll be super hard to see us compared to full moon.
So after an hour, are we waiting now? Has it been an hour?
And by the time you snap out, there's some shouting coming around. This guy just starts running around, rummaging.
Oh,
whoa. He turned sideways.
He got a bit smaller and he's weird now. There we go. That's fair. He starts running around looking for for someone, actually.
Oh.
Rummaging,
rummaging around the tents and everything.
They start to struggle a little bit to test his restraints once he finally snaps out of it.
Can you kick Gulad and tell him to stop it?
Give me another stealth check, Smog.
Piss off.
It's a bit mean. With advantage. Because you're hiding there.
Right, I roll it again then.
You're gonna beat it anyways.
16.
Yeah, after about half an hour, the guy does give up and goes back where it was. He rummages around the bed inside the tent, but that's pretty much it.
Thank God I'm small.
Yes. As night falls in, the guys over here, they start to go around to their own tents. Go in into their own tents.
I don't think you're able to see that right now. I think Kaelin sees the one guy.
So nobody's watching the prisoners?
And no, the prisoners would have been all put inside one of these tents.
Oh, okay.
All of them?
Yes, all of them.
In one tent, that's good to know.
They're prisoners. They're not exactly royalty.
No, I just want to know where they all are, it's fine.
Well, we don't get a tent, that's not fair.
I got a tent.
There.
I've got a tent.
You don't have no idea. You're in a tent.
I have a tent.
Exactly. You have no idea where they are.
It's fine. I just pick a big tent.
I'm guessing we could have seen them be escorted there because it's in.
Yes, you guys could have seen them being escorted over there.
Barely, but.
The guards are vanishing.
Yes, they're inside their own tent.
To a plane, another plane of his that. Never mind. Ruined it.
There we go.
So close.
Mm.
As you see the guards going over to that tent, and there's two more that go over to the back of the tent, while the guard drakes start to go around the tent for a while, and then they actually leave towards the cave.
That we don't see.
Yeah, you guys, from the corner of your eye, you see them disappear, basically. And the two guards at the back of the tent, they're not looking around for you guys. They're hiding from everybody else. Like, they're chatting behind the tent.
They're playing dice.
Could be.
Probably.
Well, how many hours has this been? This is about,
let's call it about 2 in the morning now.
Oh, really?
It's been a good while. You guys argued the plan, and you've seen cultists go in and out. You've seen kobolds
flying
around. And then it all started to die down to the point that there's barely anyone walking around, if there is still anyone. It is completely dark, which means there's a few people that won't be able to see anything.
Can I tell what way they're looking? From, like, peeking out from below the tent?
They're... Give me a perception check.
Oh, 6 hours?
Is it like, dim light right now, basically? With
yeah,
the, I
it
guess...
Would
the
have, it would have been dim light.
Okay.
Yeah, they're both sitting on a chair outside the tent, and they don't look like they're paying much attention to whatever's going on.
Okay, good.
They look visibly tired and annoyed that they have to be there.
I have dark vision, but I don't see it on the...
Yeah,
sure,
but you can still give me a stealth check.
Who, me?
Yeah.
Yes.
Oh.
No.
<I'm...
laughs>
No, they're still tied up.
Oh, shit.
That's gonna be fun.
No, it's not.
Where... No, so, yeah. Time to hide in another tent.
Okay. No. Oh, what?
Oh, God.
I'm going to move a bit faster.
Short rest or long rest?
Short. Well, we had the long rest, and then you used your stuff, and then
two.
We took a, sh- and
yeah,
then we took
it,
a short rest.
Yeah, it has to be a short rest, because you guys had the long rest whenever...
We got captured.
Egg! Egg!
Shh!
Egg!
Just look up. How smart.
How do I get you out?
How do you get me out?
How do I get you, well, all of you?
Well, I can get out now if you want.
Right, okay, you're talked care of. Good. No.
Oh God, he's gonna shout.
The key's in his boot.
Whose boot?
That boot.
That's boot.
What boot? Your boot!
No,
your boots.
I'll point with my boot to the other guy's
boot. Yeah.
Well, you can kick him.
Don't kick me.
The handle.
You can reach Leosin with your boots, Aaron. That's all I'm saying.
Yeah, I'll wake him up.
And Leosin just hands the boot off to Smog.
Right, have I got the key now?
Yes.
Yes, good.
The key.
Right. This is gonna come in handy.
I think it requires a check for you to remove a key from a boot.
Maybe.
Hold on. Wait.
I think it's a constitution
right.
check.
It's been weird.
Oh.
Are you eating 90 feet apart?
No, they're not 90 feet apart. I told you last time.
Right, would they be 30 feet apart, roughly? No, less?
Yeah, about 25, 30 feet apart.
Right, well, you know what, I'm doing this anyway.
What the hell are you doing?
There, that's going to use the key to unlock everybody. Why is they make...
He's not tall enough.
Yeah, you're not tall enough. Yes, Mage Hand would be able to unlock everyone.
Thanks, little man. Where's
so
my stuff at?
Leosin looks at you. Why did you free me? I must stay.
Why? Why must you stay?
I need to know why are they here.
What do you want?
Oh, they're to call the Tiamat. They want to resurrect Tiamat. Like,
well, that I know. I just need to know what they're gonna do next.
They just wanted the loot. They just stole everything. Let's go.
No, they're not
that difficult.
Shut up.
Oh, hell's bells.
He argues a little bit, but he's not really strong enough to put
Look,
a foot down and stay.
We can figure it out without you staying here, because you'll probably die if you stay here.
Fine. I'll go.
Good.
Good.
Well, you guys go get the gear, I'm getting the other people.
Everybody's gonna give me a stealth check.
Fuck's sake.
I don't have disadvantage. I still rolled an 8.
Oh yeah!
Oh dear god.
Did I even bother at this point? No, Egg doesn't sell unless he's
as soon as Glut's free. And Smog points to the weapons gun and just, let's do this! And starts running, flailing his arms towards the tent.
Yeah, I'm just gonna tear into this side of the tent. I'm not even gonna go around. I'm just gonna tear.
Shit.
Are we. So we're not together anymore? Or like, where is. Gulad's up there.
I rolled a 2, so this is where I'm at. I'm going for it.
This guy's just sticking around by the stockades, or. Where's the elf?
The elf would be accompanying you guys.
Okay. Hey, Kaelin, are you coming over here too?
Yeah. I'm throwing everybody's weapons out, looking for my stuff. It's gonna land.
Alright, I'm gonna move out again.
It's gonna land out here.
Great club. He's throwing it out. Did you throw my great club out?
I throw everything in the way just to get my stuff.
Alright. I'm gonna pick up Kaelin's bow and toss it towards him.
Sorry, as soon as you open the tent, you see the 8 prisoners over there, and they look at you, they look visibly afraid, because you are wearing a mask.
Don't talk. You'll be fine.
Did he take his mask?
Some of them are actually cowering, afraid that you're going to hit them.
You're fine. You're fine.
Did they take off Zarian's mask when they kidnapped us?
No.
No, they didn't.
I want to see that face.
They tried, but there was a pool of vomit in front of Zarian.
Oh, good, there you go. Damn, Zarian.
Oh, yeah. Oh, he probably puked from the pain, and they probably puked from seeing it.
I was assuming they puked from seeing it.
Probably the pain from them trying to yank it off.
No, because you were unconscious.
Okay, yeah. I guess that's fine, then. Are they chained up too somehow?
They're just hands bound together. They're not even shackled anywhere.
If you want to live, well, you need to live, follow me.
Cool. come with me if you want to leave.
Opportunity there.
Persuasion. Do I need to persuade them?
No. As you're being nice to them, they actually assume that you're actually trying to free them.
Now, can we see this way now? Is this actually like rubble up the hill, or...?
No, that's just rocks that fallen from the hill.
So it's pretty much just the only way out is the way we came.
Yes,
it seems like. Unless we try to go through the cave where we think maybe dogs went.
The camp's fairly empty. You guys would be able to leave easily.
Okay.
Says much to yourself.
I wouldn't put my armor on yet. I'd like throw it in my bag. Or shove it into my bag.
Oh yeah, then you wouldn't even have disadvantage on that stuff.
No, but it was still an 8.
It's still an 8. But yeah, you guys would be able to leave the camp easily. And
yeah.
After a few hours, by about maybe 10, 12 in the morning, you'd be able to reach Green Nest again. And as you reach Green Nest, everybody's gonna level up to level 3.
Woo!
Woo! Oh,
wow. And while you guys are leveling up, you will, when you arrive, Nighthill will actually pay everybody 250 gold each.
Nice.
I'm rich.
Oh, which of these is gold?
GP.
It's the GP.
None of them say GP.
They have to.
No, they don't.
It's CPSPE.
Oh, wait, never mind. What's at the side?
We don't have an APP.
250?
I will teleport everybody back to Green Nest. As I will mystically teleport. As soon as I'll not get everybody the other side. But yeah. Water skin?
Where's the gold at again?
I was drinking water, I guess.
If you go down to your equipment, like your backpack and everything, on the left side it's the fourth one down.
Yeah,
really
it says GP on a
really
faded.
Really
yeah,
bad.
Yeah.
Yeah, it is.
250?
Yeah, that's super
yeah,
tiny.
250.
And 5 pounds worth of gold. I like that.
Level 3!
You would like it if I was actually counting the weight.
It's only 105 pounds.
So again, if you guys want to, you can take the average, or you can roll for it, and if it's lower than the average, you will take your average.
What do we roll again? Hit dice, isn't it?
Yeah. There's a D something on your hit dice.
Is one? Oh, there
so
it is.
So, Zarian, that's a 9 for you?
Yep.
Smog. That's a 9
oh,
for you.
Yes.
Holy hell.
So mine is a 2d12. I rolled 2.
No, you just d12. Just click on d12 and it will roll for you.
Nice, great. You said I can take the average? 6?
That was an average for you, Greg. You will take your average, which is a 6 plus your constitution.
Wizard.
So you would.
So I got 8?
Yeah, you get 8.
That's a sorcerer. Not a sorcerer. I want a sorcerer.
You're the only one left to roll, Kaelin. Don't forget to increase your maximums as well on your character sheet.
Oh, yeah.
As you guys all healed and now you're bursting your HP bar.
Put the wee dice and let's come up with an input value. What do we put in there?
One.
Hit dice?
One.
Oh, it
does? Yeah.
Yeah,
that's
what
I was asking.
That's probably
not an
update. Ooh, that's a
10.
No,
oh,
wow.
Nice.
Damn, girl.
Woo!
I'm jealous.
So you should change both your values, the one above HP and the one under HP, to plus 10.
Nice.
And the other, you should change the other one as well. There you go. Right, going through. I think you get your archetype. Darian.
Yes.
Yep. Kaylin also
really
gets
want.
Her archetype, which if you want you can reveal, if you don't you don't have to. But that's pretty much gonna be obvious in about
I'm a dead
10-15 seconds. let's see what our barbarian gets.
I get 3 rages.
Pretty great.
Back in a minute.
Alright. Barbarian at level 3. You get your tumble path as well.
Nice.
So
I go down the Oath of Redemption so then I can no longer fight. Ha ha ha.
Jeez.
You can be part of the Berserker, Totem Warrior. You see the other ones. Where is Zanathar's?
I think I wanted to go down the totem path of the wolf, I believe it was.
Just in case. There's 3 more on another book.
Yeah, I think I looked at them. I wasn't too sure.
Well, if you want to go Totem Warrior, that's fine.
I think I looked at the other one, and I think one was like kind of paladin-y. Thunder something.
Aha.
There is Path of the Ancestral Guardian, which basically calls on spirits of honored ancestors to protect others. Path of the Storm Herald, filled with a rage that channels the primal magic of the storm. And Path of the Zealot,
filled
by a religious zeal that visits destruction on foes. Yeah, it's a bit religiously.
Yeah, I wasn't gonna go with that at all, for sure.
Alright, so you can go Totem Warrior, no problem.
Yeah, I wanted to go wolf because everybody gets advantage if they're in 5 feet of me against enemies.
Oh yeah,
which I thought was super good. And I was talking to Zarian about the other levels, and it said I could take like the bear for the next one, or the eagle for the one after that, or whatever I wanted to.
Yeah. Yeah, you have the 3 choices. So you're gonna get Beast Sense and Speak with Animals as spells. There's Gulad. Oh, there's your 3. You don't have any spell cast in here. But yeah, you can.
Beast Sense and
then
on roll 20, I gotta include myself.
Dot.
Yeah, if you're stuff from Xanathar's, yeah, you need to put it yourself.
Yeah. Some of them never got added.
Yeah.
They missed some.
Right, so where's I need to grab Barbarian here. Totem Warrior Barbarian 5th edition. There we go. That's what I wanted.
So page 51, if that helps.
No, it's just so I can copy it.
Oh.
Right, so if I go into your spells...
Let me check some merch. We're using able to use Xanathar's, aren't we?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Good.
Alrighty.
So where does it say I get these spells?
It's page 50, you got where it says Spirit Seeker.
Trying to figure out bells.
Okay. Oh, there we go. It is Beast Sense.
Nice! That's awesome.
Oh, Zonflash doesn't have wither spells? Oh, it does.
There's also no Beast Sense on on the SRD. Speak with animals, I know there was. Yes, speak with animals. Shows us level 1 spell, but you cast it as a ritual.
And rituals take
10 minutes. Oh.
10 minutes.
Okay.
But it doesn't use a spell slot, so.
And I have to have material components? Is anything in here?
No, it's just because you're a totem warrior.
Okay, cool. Because I remember in 4E,
maybe
I had to have components for some things.
So, Beast Sense as a ritual, one action.
Ow! Son of a bitch.
Concentration up to an hour.
Oh my
right?
God, that's so much easier to do.
You touch a wheeling beast.
I'm literally doing exactly what you're doing right now.
I need to go.
There you go. That should be working now. And you should have it on your character part as well. There you go. I will filter it into level 1.
Sweet.
So now it only shows your level 1 spells. So this sense should be working. Yeah, cast as a ritual, spell level 1, and it shows. Same with animals, ritual, level 1, speak with animals. There you go. Totem spirit. Which goes on your class, well, your traits, racial traits. You get your totem spirit.
I think since I already have the claw of the, what was it, owlbear, I think I'm just gonna add more claws, like, around a necklace. So it's just gonna be like the wolf claw, the bear claw, and eagle talon. And
yeah.
And so I'm just gonna add one more to the necklace.
Totem. And I'll just add a second one and I'll put wolf. And I'll just
Wow.
Wolf. There you go. I have totem spirit and your wolf. While you're raging, your friends have advantage on melee attack rolls against any creature within 5 feet of you that is hostile to you. The spirit of the wolf the wolf makes you a leader of hunters. There you go, you are ready. I take it our druid and our paladin don't need any help. They know what they're doing, I think.
Just
I'll just go on to Alana once more, just to be sure. If I missed anything, you roll your stuff. Let me see. At level 3, what you get? Primeval Awareness. Let me see if it's on your character sheet already. There should be if I just change your level 2 into level 3. Yeah. So now it should be somewhere. Yeah, Primeval Awareness. You have an innate ability to communicate with beasts and they recognize you as a kindred spirit. Through sounds and gestures you can communicate with them. And you can feel, you can know their needs basically. And you can focus, determine if any of your favorite enemies are within 5 freaking miles of you.
Wow.
Wow, nice.
Yeah, wow.
With beast sense, do I control the beast, or it just says I see and hear what they see?
Yeah. You're
okay, that's it. So it just does whatever it wants, and I just can see.
Yeah.
Okay.
Gotcha. It's a less powerful version of what Moondancer does with smart. And you need to add your thingy. There we go. Control C. Does this show there by any chance? No, it doesn't. Basically, that's just that, and I'll add the rest between sessions, but you know what that does. Do you want to describe what happens, Kaelin, or do you want me to describe so you're not stressing your voice?
I'll let you do it.
Alright, so let me go and grab what I need. So, this is back here. So, during your travels back to Dunas, you spend some time taking a long rest, because of course it's over more or less a day of journey. You take a long rest, and you do notice that Kaelin sits around near the campfire, and kind of looks like the way she is usually sleeping. Well, not sleeping, but sleeping in her trance. But she's muttering a few words and waving her hands from time to time. And suddenly, everybody can give me a perception check. Sorry for interrupting all that you are doing.
What are you talking?
Perceptions. Because everybody's apparently it's really good at perception suddenly.
Now they are.
Yep.
As you notice, coming from the tree line, a big ruffling, and looks like something really big's coming towards you guys. As this big, massive bear comes out of the woods and goes straight for Kaelin.
I'm ready my weapon.
Stops near Kaelin as she opens her eyes and pets this big animal as he fondles near her, lies down. You happy enough, like this,
Yeah, okay, he's just meat buster. He'll be joining us for a bit.
That sounds good.
Great, a bear. Great. Just.
What are you? Are you jealous? I think you're jealous.
Just because I'm not the loudest beast around, I guess.
No, that thing's probably quieter than you still.
What the hell? Why is there a dog here?
That's a bear, not a dog. I know for you people at your size, it's a little bit hard to tell the difference.
It's just like the way there's an owl, now there's a bear, and there's a turtle that transforms into other animals.
We're a traveling circus.
Basically, yeah. By the end of this campaign, it's gonna be a freaking walking zoo.
Yeah.
It's not gonna blend in very well.
Well, technically, your bear is as stealthy as you.
Yes. Yeah, that's true.
My only concern is how to get it across chasms and up mountains. Because it's probably not as agile, or is it? Is it as agile?
Well, he is sort of agile. You don't know how much do you know? Well, you know slightly about bears.
He knows how to
roll.
Sure, give me a nature check. Just because it's so rare to actually have a nature check.
It's great. Oh, wow. That's terrible.
You do know that bears usually do climb trees sometimes, so you'd assume they're sort of agile.
That's alright.
He's still jealous.
I still have my hammer. As I'm shaking it at you and the bear, like, back and forth, just like, say something. Both of you.
You know how well that hammer works for that guy outside the gates, remember?
Oh, fuck you. You wouldn't have lasted half as long as I would.
Who am I still hearing pages flicking back and forth? Is that Johnny?
Yeah, I'm trying to figure it.
Do you need help?
No, I'm just trying to figure what spell I want. My last one.
You get level 3 spells or level 2s?
Level 2s. Two level 2s.
Yeah.
And two level 2 spots. Slots.
Don't forget you get your level up preparedness as well.
Alright, it goes up by 1.
Yep.
How big is the bear?
Medium size.
I mean, like, physically. Like, if he stands up, is he as tall as me? Is he 800 pounds? Is he...
Yeah, he would be as big as you.
I'm eyeing up the bear.
On his four, he's bigger than small.
It's not hard.
Oh, I don't see hard.
No.
Well, it'd be nice to kill him. Maybe she would let you ride the bear.
At least it's not a spider smog.
A smog turns into a spider and crawls on.
Smog can turn into spider.
I think he meant Agnes.
Yeah, no, I'm just okay. Well, I think you get, I don't think you get it yet, but can't you get the spell that you can, summon a bunch of animals? I think.
Smog?
At what?
Smog.
What level?
I think it's like a level 3 spell. I know Druid gets it. But you can, like, summon a bunch of animals.
I don't know, actually. Hold on.
I can't even remember which spell it is.
I can't remember. I know I was eyeing it for my other druid.
Where the hell is it in the book?
On the spells.
I know. Yes. I grasp.
Who uses the book for it to look for spells?
Well, me, obviously. Come on. No, I'm there. I'm there. Go away.
I can find all your. I found all your level 2 spells.
Where's?
Oh, you can have a snowball sword.
Yeah.
Yes.
I don't know what that spell's been called. No, I don't think so.
Snowlock snowball sword.
No, not that one.
Buster's perception.
Oh, the.
You fixed what?
Talking to
Milan. I can get a phantom steed at level 3.
I fixed the perception on your bear because he should have more.
Maybe you don't have that. Oh, you can summon demons.
I can get a gaseous form, but I become a big fart. Sorry, a tiny fart.
Tiny fart. No, it's not. Right. And you also have the climb speed for the bear as well, because I forgot to put it on.
I've main sword now, just so you know.
The bear is actually faster than everybody else.
Well, it's a bear.
Of course it is.
Conjurer. Yeah, you don't have that.
No.
And it climbs at the same speed as everybody else runs.
Wow.
Oh, you got invisibility to cameras. It's under a pick on it, so. I don't know why they edited it.
I can't remember what you get from Elemental Evil, if there's anything at level 2. Elemental Evil is...
Nice, mate.
I have no idea.
Base, isn't it?
Maximilians, maybe. No, it's Anathers.
Elemental Evil's out of the abyss, no?
Oh.
It's Anathers.
Where are we on this map? Oh, way down there.
Yeah, we're down there. No, that's not...
What the hell?
I can't remember.
I'm not seeing anything around Mental Evil.
No, it's the appendix.
Oh, okay. It's in multiple things.
Like Snowlox.
Yeah. It's like Snowlox is also part of Elemental Evil.
No, it's just that weird appendix that has the spells on it.
Yeah. Let's see, Dragon Breath.
Pretty sure. Oh, there we go. It's here.
Dust Sorcerer, Devil.
Warlock, Wizard.
Dust Second. Devil, Maximilian's Earthing Grass. Pyrotechnics.
Skywrite, Snowball and Swarm. And Aghanazar's Scorcher. What the hell is that?
It's weird.
Oh, you don't need that, John. That's good.
Why not? That looks fun.
Aghanazar's Scorcher, a line of roaring flame 30 feet long and 5 feet wide emanates from you in a direction you choose.
Yeah.
Each creature in the line must make a dexterity saving throw. A creature takes 3d8 fire damage on a failed save, or half as much on a successful one. But you also need the red dragon scale.
Yeah, I didn't take that because of that.
Oh, you actually took that?
I can get that, yeah.
Yeah, you can get that.
But it doesn't consume it, so. And it's more the stuff that consumes gets annoying. I'll be right back.
I picked something nicer.
At level 2?
Yes.
From where?
One from Xanathar's and one from the handbook.
Something nicer from Xanathar's?
Well, I think it's nicer.
I actually didn't memorize most of the spells from Xanathar's, so I don't have an idea.
If you go and look at my cheat, you'll see it.
Yeah, I'm trying to guess.
Yeah, good luck.
I can see just a list of wizard spells.
There's quite a lot.
Level 2, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11.
Yeah, well, there's one from there and one from Xanathar's, so.
No, I'm trying to guess the one from Xanathar's.
Alright, go for it. I'm not going to tell you either way, unless you can look and see, but I'm telling you.
It's probably this.
Hmm.
It's probably this one. I'm pretty sure that it got my eye as soon as I looked at it, so.
Oh, really?
Oh no, it's not!
Well, what do you think it was?
I thought it was Dragon's Breath.
Oh, right. No.
What?
I actually thought you would pick Dragon's Breath. Well, unless it's not that great.
We need pyrotechnics. We need fireworks, ma'am.
We need fireworks. It's gonna be Jubilee from X-Men. There you go, that's you told off. Right, so is everybody good?
Yep.
Yeah.
Right. I didn't realize we have all these Xanathar spells.
Do you want us to wait on you?
No, you can go.
So after you guys got to a green nest and have your rest and all, Leostin comes to everybody and just says to you guys, after all you've done already for me personally and for the people of Green Nest, I do hate to ask anything more from you, but the need is great, and I dare to hope that you can aid me one more time. I need you to return to the cultist's camp. You know your way around it now. If the cultists are preparing to conduct another raid, or a large body of them marches away, or if anything substantial is carried into or out of that cave, I need to know. If you have a chance to get into the camp and look around again, that would be the ideal way to spot anything that's changed. I don't recommend you guys get captured again, he says to you guys with a smile.
It's not like we were trying. I look over at Egg.
I'll look
hey,
over.
You know what? We wouldn't have escaped anyway. I tried to run as a spider, fast as hell, and I still got caught. So no matter what.
Mind in the sky and anywhere but anything.
I am prepared to offer you some gold for it. I will give you 150 gold each of you for it.
For what?
For spying. going back spying. To the Raiders camp.
What else is there to learn? There's hundreds of them.
Well, there's a lot of things to learn.
On the way out. There's a cave.
You were running.
Monster dogs went in.
You were running. You screamed. You ran into a tent. You grabbed some stuff and you left. I don't think you saw that much, to be honest.
We went out the same way we came in. There's nothing to see. I'll take the gold now. I just like pulled out my hand, just waiting, expectantly.
There is a cave at the back of the camp. I do need to know what's in there.
Four monster dogs. I keep holding out my hand.
Well, if you do this, I will pay you. You will, though, have to meet me in Eterel, because I will have to go there and meet someone.
Smell that.
Let me see if I can find where it's written. Oh, there, Eterel.
I don't mind it. I'm sure that we could probably find a better place to hide instead of right next to the place so we can watch.
What?
Thanks.
If by any chance, whenever you arrive at Eldorado, if I'm not there, please do speak with Onthar Froom. He's one of my friends. And he will know what to do.
He smelled that.
He's handing him a paper. I don't know where I get paper from, but he had the paper somewhere.
At the top it just says like quest log.
He tells to speak with the Paladin Onthar Froom.
And then I switch everything that he said into Celestial, scratch out what he said.
That's a bit mean. Nobody else can read this.
Exactly. That's the point. Anything else?
Not that I can remember. Just don't get captured.
Yes. As long as somebody doesn't make a big loud noise again. Or if they do make a big loud noise, at least talk your way out of it.
I'm too intrigued by the bear. I'm just like shrugging, waving him off. I'm feeding the bear jerky and petting it, just watching it drool.
Jerky?
Yeah. It's from the rations.
Oh, okay.
I'm sure there's like jerky and cheese and bread and shit.
There's jerky, cheese, bread, and shit.
Yeah, and shit. I feed the shit to Moondancer then.
Yeah, the bear does eat the jerky really happily.
And it just goes through him and comes out on the other side.
Where is...
forgot Moondancer, yeah.
Oh, by the way, we got this. Do you think you could do us a favor? Do you think you could take this to a blacksmith and get it a little bit bigger?
giving him the guy's half plate or whatever it was. Splint.
Splint?
Yeah.
Well, I'm sure you'd be able to find a blacksmith over in Eltral.
It's the pain to carry this thing, if you know.
I'm still Please. Not. I still haven't recovered enough to be able to carry stuff with me. As you can see, I do travel light.
But I think you'd be taking a horse or something. A pony.
A donkey!
No, I actually plan to walk to Eldorado.
Oh. Shit. Well then, okay.
So, do you guys head off towards the camp again?
I guess. Are we going back already?
Well, you guys had the rest, and you guys had a long rest, so...
Yeah.
Sure.
No time like the present. They're all still probably pissed off that we escaped. Hey, we'll go back and say hi.
Was
oh, we're going, oh, that camp. I thought you meant...
Oh, we'll go and talk to... Oh, we'll try to find what's his name.
Him.
He's no. Neeson.
Wait, I thought we got paid from somebody in the fort. Are we not in the fort?
We're not in the fort. Well, are we
I thought somebody paid us for finding him.
No. Happened. No. Unless we got paid beforehand. I don't remember us getting paid beforehand.
I don't know.
I'm not even sure if you guys, if he offered to pay us anything.
I don't think so either, but we'll at least, no. I'll at least return them to him and see how
No, you guys got the 250 gold each was from Night Hill.
Yeah.
Because you guys found the raider camp.
Yeah.
Yeah, so we're back at the fort right now. Okay, that's where I was getting
you. Back at the keep, yes.
Yeah,
I just didn't move your characters. Cause...
No, that's fine.
Yeah. Like, I'll go and talk to Neeson, see how his wounds, healing and whatnot.
He would have been actually with Leosin whenever you guys were talking.
Okay. Well, like, when we first got... Oh, I guess he would have also saw us coming anyways. Okay.
Right, so, you guys head on back to the camp.
Great.
Because it's an awesome idea.
Great.
Just back and forth.
So I say, let's go on to the other side of the camp where it's a bigger ridge so that it's easier for them not to see us.
Yeah.
Because I think, is that like forests and whatnot, or?
It's mostly plains.
So like over here by the cave?
There's different stuff on this map.
Don't be nosy.
Well, sorry, but that's where it opened up.
There is. As you return to the camp, you find the camp mostly abandoned. The stinking huts on level 1 have been burned. The huts on the second level and both of the guard towers do remain. And everybody can give me a perception check.
How long were you even gone?
A day.
Okay.
I don't see shit.
No, you don't see shit. Jalen doesn't see shit. Gulag doesn't see shit.
Alright,
hold on.
I'm still too interested in the bear. I don't know
Frank
why.
Does. At least one of us does.
One dancer does. Oh, you can give one for the bear as well, if you want.
Yeah, there we go.
Bear.
More perception checks, the better.
Buster!
Second on the screen. Oh, yeah. Moondancer's list's royally messed up.
It's fine for me.
No, it's only showing two skills.
I've seen your role, but nobody else see. Because I forgot to swap that from... to the GM to the other one. There you go. It was still a 20 from the bearer.
Wow.
Freaking bear. 20.
Can she talk to the bear naturally?
No, but she can understand. She can understand the bear.
Okay.
Yeah, they have a special connection. Basically, Smog, Moondancer, Egg, and the bear. They do notice that even though there's tracks going in all directions, you notice that most of the wagon tracks and the pack animal tracks have been moved towards the west. Still left in the camp, there is a few people walking about, and you barely see anybody else. Yes, those people.
I can't see him, so.
Yeah, I'm
well,
unless somebody says something.
Somehow the tiny guy, the turtle, and the bear see.
Yes.
I assume everybody sees just Smog tapping his chest and casting something.
What's going on? Why is everything burnt down? What is Where is it?
It would appear they got attacked.
It doesn't seem they got attacked.
Or they burnt all their own stuff.
Obviously, burnt down everything.
It seems like they left.
I guess we're all slowly walking in.
Mm-hmm. Somebody drag me. Sorry, I was still putting spells in.
Okay.
Oh, you can stay there. We'll just consider that you're walking. I'll move you. As you're walking into camp, you see these four figures walking out.
I'll wave.
As he does.
They wave back at you and they slowly approach you. You can now see that they're carrying bows and they're heading towards the Agassi. Just, yes, hello?
You don't happen to know where everybody went, do you?
Well, they left.
Yes, they attacked. I'm still on this.
No.
Okay, I'll make this easy. My name's Zarian. We were coming to watch the camp, and it would appear that they all left.
Yes.
I think they might be a little bit mad at us.
I don't know.
I kind of figured that part. Are they elvish?
No, they're human.
Okay.
Well, one's a human, another one's a half-elf. The other two are human as well, let's call it that.
Okay. So, if you'll be kind, I was just wondering why you guys are...
Well, we hunt. The plains have a lot of food. And they notice Kaelin. I assume Kaelin would be the next poster. They do notice Kaelin just completely ignore you and just move around towards Kaelin. Ah, I see, you're a fellow hunter.
These type of people.
As Kaelin stares in silence at them.
She vanished.
She might have.
She
can ping herself. She probably silenced her microphone and forgot.
Exactly what had happened. Where did the rest of them go?
Most of them left, actually. We're just here hunting for the ones that are still there. They pay us for the food, so we'll stay here as long as they pay us.
Her?
Sorry?
You're not with the other guys, you're just for her?
Oh yeah, they're just paying us for the food that we hunt. So I don't even care what the hell they're doing, as long as they keep paying us.
Shouldn't the wind?
Well, they all carried crates and everything in wagons and hauled all the way towards west.
When did they leave?
About 12 hours ago, maybe? As he turns around to the other ones, and the other ones just nod. Yeah, probably 12 hours, more or less. It's whenever Richard went off hunting, wasn't it? So yeah, about 12 hours.
And where they were going or why?
No idea, we just saw a load of them sounding the alarm and running around, and then suddenly the lady got out and started shouting at them to pack up and leave.
Okay.
They nod back at you and they just walk past everybody and leave.
Are we supposed to be checking a cave or something? I don't care anymore.
The tent's still here and whatnot, or?
Most of them are all burnt down.
Okay.
They're just ragged pieces of cloth now.
Thanks.
Well, it's surprising that they decide to just destroy the tents.
Well,
I think they might be a little pissed off still.
For the sake of it, can I just say you guys find the cave?
Yeah.
Because you guys are walking so slowly that it's time
to go. I was like, we're having a conversation.
I wasn't sure if there was anything that might happen or anything, so I didn't want to just jump.
No. As we're walking past this one, is this one still burning?
Yeah.
Never
mind. I'm like, not notice anything inside the tent, if there was anything left.
Not of value now. We are gonna move to the other side. Actually, whenever you guys are going up there, I want another perception check from everybody.
Oh, nice!
Yeah, you were looking at the tent.
I'm mumbling to myself about how I didn't find anything in the tent.
That's you.
Wow.
My screen flickers every time I grab a character sheet.
Lana's using weighted dice.
Is she?
Yeah, look.
I wasn't even looking. Yeah, it probably is. And that's probably the bear afterwards. Oh yeah. You do notice inside the cave, even though it goes a bit dark, you do notice there's something there.
We all have torches, right, in our packs?
Nope, don't need them.
Maybe that'll use them.
Oh, yeah. I have dark sense, but or dark vision, but I don't think. Egg? Egg's the only one. Right?
I'll just make a flame in my hand.
No, I have no torches.
Nor do I, actually. No. Well,
I got
well
10.
Done.
I can just hand out torches. I give everybody a torch.
I don't need a torch.
I think it's only you, Egg, and the bear that don't see in the dark.
I see fine. I have dark vision.
Oh, then it's just Egg and the bear.
I have a shield. I can't really exactly hold the torch that easily, so.
You also have a cantrip that does stuff.
Yeah, I could use a cantrip too.
That's what I use. Oh, I use my.
I don't exactly need to use it right now, though.
Well, I wasn't worried about it. I mean, I don't know how dark. How dark is dark vision? It's just pitch black I can see, regardless?
It's black and white.
Yeah.
So it's like watching an old TV.
Okay, but if it's pitch black, I can still see.
Yeah.
Then I'm not worried about the torch, then. I don't even pull out a torch. I just assume that...
Well, you do notice... Let's see who notices. There's so many perceptions in the room.
I'm still walking forward. Because I don't see anything.
Moon, Dancer, Kaelin, and Buster do notice a figure running off into the cave inside. As you guys enter the cave. Ah.
Oh. It's dark.
It's supposed to be
there. There we go. To the very left hand side of the screen.
Oh, there it is.
Yeah. Left hand side of the screen.
Oh, okay.
You've left Buster behind.
I'm blind!
Don't you?
Poor Buster.
I'll go and grab Buster in a second. Hang on, don't move.
I'm just going to about where I would already been.
Stop running and run.
I figured I'd probably be about 15 feet in front of everybody. I didn't see anything, so I just kept walking.
I actually did thought I had music for this, but apparently I don't. I just swapped for this one. Thought I had cave ambiance, but I don't have. No problem. Where is Buster? Buster was left in the raider camp.
He's using the fog of war in this now.
Not the advanced one, because it just got so slow that annoys me.
Alright, that's fair enough.
Yeah, I started
there is fog of war. It's just not in here.
Yeah.
So you guys can position yourselves behind Zarian, more or less. Before you guys... Oh, you can start going in, actually.
Oh my god, that is amazing on the map. Holy cow.
You're right there, Nick. I mean, Gulag.
Actual dark fishing.
I just love the field of vision and the fog. I think that's awesome. Are we just gonna keep walking? Okay.
As you guys walk, the cave quickly goes from... Where is it? Quickly goes from about 40 feet high ceilings to about 15.
Oh, hell, really?
The actual cave itself. Yes, really.
Tell everyone to be kind of wary because I'd seen somebody up ahead.
I assume Egg still reckon out. You didn't see anything.
I didn't see anything.
Okay. No.
And I rolled a 16. I didn't see anything. I rolled the same as the bear.
Yeah, you seen a figure running around inside.
So
as you go. As you go around that corner, everybody stops. Where exactly where they are? You were one up, Zarian. We are rolling for initiative.
Okay. Oh god.
Okay. For something.
Suddenly, you see two figures coming out of the shadows. Can you actually see the second figure?
I can see two of them. Yeah.
I can see both of them.
It's just slightly
different. I just look. Hi, ladies!
Slightly slow for me as well.
You know, you need to really work on your handcuffs. They're really, really bad.
Really? They honestly rolled the same for both of them. It's just you left rolling for yourself and Egg as well. Oh no, Kevin's there. It's just Egg left.
Trying to find us. I'm out here because I was.
Left hand side. Kind of middle.
Oh, well, there might be something wrong then. I just see blackness.
Oh, that's because you don't have dark vision.
He can't see anything!
Alright. Well, I mean, I used my flame, so I should be able to see.
Oh, did you? I didn't even know.
Yeah. It was about 20/20.
What?
I think it's 20/20.
Should we?
It is running a little slow.
Yeah, freaking follow up.
Yeah. I use Firefox because it seems to work better for it.
Let's see, it is.
Might actually have to try it.
30. No, no, sorry. 10 feet.
Because Chrome, 10? You have to. 10, 10.
Bright light and 10 feet, dim light and 10 feet. Additional 10 feet.
Chrome, you need to turn on the accelerator for it to work. But the accelerator is horrible for Twitch.
Yeah. Doesn't work with OBS.
Yeah.
Just realized why my freaking windows were acting up. I had my book pressing on the space.
Okay, so as soon as I see myself, I will roll for initiative.
Sight of 360. Aha!
There I am. Alright. I'll just assume my number moves.
You can barely see. You can see Smog.
I'm gonna chill with Smog.
And the black bear is us.
Oh my god, it's really as far as you can see? Oh, jeez.
It's like, it's 20 feet, like 10 bright, 10 dim.
It's like this for me.
Yeah, you should be able to see 60 feet.
Yeah. So. That was Egg. So let's send us again. And. Wait a second. 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30!
Well, it's their turn already.
Yes, because they were ambushing all of you.
Okay.
But me.
I'll miss.
Of course.
I'll just pat him on top of the head. Like, one of these days you'll actually be able to do something.
25.
30.
Yeah, this one's gone. Reach. And we're back at the top. Galen!
How far away from me is he?
10 feet. 10 feet.
Yeah.
Both of them.
So back up, fire, back up, fire.
Walk forward and hit with a short sword.
Or that also works. Or maybe not. That misses.
Wow.
So that's your turn?
That's, yeah, I'm not back in the way.
Do I have line of sight on any of them? Like, as in, is anybody in my road?
There's
well, apart from that one.
You.
Yeah.
You could see that one, yes.
I can see that one.
Yes.
Right. Guess what? Oh, hold on a minute. No. Screw this, I just can't do that. I'm gonna cast. Please hit. Nope, never mind.
No. Doesn't hit.
I'm gonna dive behind this.
Hide behind the rock.
Yep.
One down, sir.
Wait, how tall is this? 15 feet?
Yes.
Oh, she can still fly in 15 feet.
She can. She flies about 2 feet away from the ceiling, dodging all the stalactites.
You're gonna be mean. How tall are these guys?
They're about 5.5 feet.
Right, it's gonna fly 10 foot. Well, you. Where's my. Oh, there.
Your flyby. That misses.
And it flies back over to. It's not like here. Here. That's it.
Big. You can't see anything.
So,
you've seen
I see smog.
And a bear's
smog.
Ass.
And you've
I
seen him
see
throw.
The bear's ass. Oh, I do see the bear's ass, just barely.
Just.
I can't really tell what that is, so I'm gonna run over here to smog.
You did see smog throw in like a little ball of fire and then running back there. So.
Like smog, what are you firing at?
Just shoot the darkness.
Darkness is everywhere. I'll just keep guard with you.
Yeah, that sounds good.
My turn.
Be my shield.
Right. That guy gets to go. He is gonna attack you, Caelan. Twice.
Ooh.
I take it.
Well.
Only one hit for one damage. The other guy is going to attack Zion once again.
Oh.
25 and a 20.
Wow.
That'll both hit.
So that is 11.
Yep.
Thank God for a level up.
Yeah.
Good, use that anger.
His slash is
makes
twice
you do
it,
better.
And then he pats you on the head.
Don't worry, it didn't hurt.
I'm gonna move in and attack this one that's attacking, sorry.
Sure.
Just smash on the head.
That hits for a butt-ton
yeah.
of damage.
Wow.
Holy hell.
And everybody has advantages at both of these two guys because they're within
yes.
5 feet.
They will. Alright, Buster.
They're wearing armor, yeah?
Yes, they are.
Sit on them.
Sit on them. He can still attack.
I'm gonna try and fight at the one that was attacking Caelan there.
Sure.
With advantage.
With advantage, so you can roll again.
Nice.
That hits.
Much better.
I'll take the first damage, which will be 9. Just grabs onto one of his arms and just shakes around. I almost spend my headphones out of my head. Zarian, it's finally you.
Yep, I'm just going to type a guy in the front with my Morningstar. 18 for 6.
You smash him against that stalagmite right there.
So how's your day going? How's the
basically,
I don't think that one's talking. I'm going to just go right there. I think there's something wrong with your friend. He's not breathing.
Caitlin, you're up.
A-Colt held his action.
He can't see any of them.
He still can't see.
Yeah, I'm gonna take a
seat. He only moved.
Pick up like a rock and just start chiseling away with my claws on it to kind of make a little.
Over here. That's all we can see.
Yeah, I'm not even gonna participate. I'm just gonna pick up, find like a rock on the ground and just start like chiseling, sculpting it.
Making a tiny turtle.
Make small talk with Smog.
Make small talk? What?
Small talk.
No pun intended.
You're up.
Jeez.
Okay, I'm gonna hit him with a short sword, but I don't wanna kill him.
Okay.
Best to kill him.
Oh!
Wow.
Yeah. That does it. You knock him unconscious.
All I can hear one ear is mm-hmm. I just look at A and go, what are you on about?
Sorry. This piece is coming along great.
Egg, do you need a light?
No, I'm good.
Are you sure? You look a bit dark down here. Nala casts light cantrip onto my Morningstar. Basically on the inside of it. It'll be like the red glow that you see like in submarines and whatnot.
Basically a flare.
No, not a flare. It's different than that, but
it's a beacon.
Basically.
How big of a glow is that?
20 feet. It's a light cantrip.
Pretty good.
I nudge Egg and go, Egg, follow me.
Let me see.
Oh, there we go.
20 dim, 20
right.
Oh, I can actually do that part.
It's a shortcut.
Excellent.
Excellent.
There we go.
Look. Look who's here. Oh, look.
Hey,
That would be Bob, and that one, I didn't get his name, he's unconscious. I'm going to use my lay on hands on myself, or 11, so I'm back up to full hit points.
I only got hit for 1, didn't I?
Yes, you only got hit for 1.
Because I keep changing it on the token to 29, and it keeps switching back to 20 for some reason.
That's because you were changing on Buster, not yours.
Do we really need that guy? Or the maybe?
Galen is at 29.
Cheers. Tiny spring.
Nice ominous red light.
Yes. Are you logging through Moondancer?
Yes.
You do notice that this entrance here ends in a 10-foot drop-off to your right. There's a few board steps that are roughly hewn into a natural stone ramp. The cavern below is carpeted with a profusion of fungi ranging from a few inches high to nearly as tall as a human adult.
Jeez.
Two paths lead through the fungi, one on the right and one on the left. It's like there's fungi in that room and there's a path that leads around them. and it's sort of like one path leads around there, and another path leads through there.
Okay.
More or less.
So if this guy that's unconscious isn't waking up anytime soon, should we just kill him before we head on?
That we can tie him up and wait till later, but yeah.
Actually, that would go more or less like that.
Because he's going to be asleep for at least an hour.
That'd be much use.
Nah.
Somebody else could.
Hey,
you
want to
smash him, huh? Just without a question, he just immediately just.
Just smashes the guy.
Just ends him and then walks off. Let's go.
And he is dead as well.
So it appears that we have two paths around the mushrooms.
Can you make
So Zarian, all of this is mushrooms?
Can you make Zarian a source of light? So I can see.
Oh. Yeah, no, I'm not sure how to make the aura.
I think.
Oh, you should be able to. There might be a way.
I'm pretty sure Miguel's got to do it.
Make it so auras can be seen by others, but I'm not sure how.
You can click your token and make it a source of light.
Yeah.
Yeah, but I think if I do that, you see 60 feet.
Yeah, I do see quite a bit. All right, forget it.
That's fair enough. It's not gonna change that much.
It's okay. Yeah. I was planning on turning into my spider forms.
Yeah. And if you go by the red light, then you can tell like what you can and can't see. So.
Right.
That's fair enough if you want to keep like that. I don't mind.
Yeah.
It doesn't change that much. It's honestly, it's 20 feet, which to me is almost out of the screen.
Yeah.
I'm gonna throw my little statue I've been making into my pack.
I'm going to test the steps first.
You're gonna test the steps first?
Can you make
the wood?
Give me a perception check?
Yes.
Sorry, Smog, what were you looking for?
Just
I can't see any
bodies.
Right,
what's on them?
Scimitars.
Nothing else?
Black leather armor, dragon, cult of the dragon regalia. As in their armor's adornments.
No. Like notes or anything like that? No.
No.
Do you give my spider 60 feet of dark sense so I can see?
Sure.
Dark vision, I mean.
This is so slow. There we go. 60. And there.
I can see.
I can see everything!
I can see.
And I rolled a 16 16 perception.
You do notice that it seems like the steps are rigged to some sort of trap.
It appears there's a trap on the steps.
I'm just gonna start climbing down the face of the.
I wanted to proceed like over here, just to see what I could see.
That's stalactite. Stalagmite.
Well, I just want to see, like, there's no.
Oh, you're trying to look at the.
Perception check.
You're trying to look at the fungi to determine best path.
Yeah. Well, he seems like he's looking that way, so I wanted to look this way at the secondary path.
Sure. Give me a nature check.
Oh, nature. Okay.
Is Mundasser looking.
I got a negative! Why you choose int, man? I don't have it.
Is Moondancer looking at the other parts?
I'm not talking through Moondancer's eyes.
No. Oh. No, they're fungi. There's a tiny path that goes in between them.
How high is the roof from down here?
25 feet.
Okay, I'm gonna climb the walls and go upside down on the roof. Whoop. And I'm gonna start moving forward.
Oi, hold up! Damn it, egg!
To you. Chitter, chitter, chitter. I'm gonna try and hide up here, so I'll give you a stealth check if you want.
Sure. as you know, you're hidden.
So we can go down the other way, or somebody can figure out how to disarm the trap.
I look at Kaylin immediately.
Or we could throw a body on the trap and hope for the best.
The shifty one might be good with traps. I got plus one to sleight of hand.
They know about traps.
Smog?
Nope. Not touching it.
Don't you spec an index? I got plus one.
I guess we can go down the ledge. It's only 10 feet.
And there's a wall of mushrooms underneath the cliff?
Yep. There's mushrooms everywhere. Well, fungi.
Down there, though, yeah?
Yes. Well, give me a nature check.
Maybe.
Do I notice anything out here?
As far as you know, they are harmless.
He's booking it. I don't even see him anymore.
Wait, where is he?
Never mind, I found him.
Hang on. Get back here. As you get there, the ceiling gets higher and higher. It gets about 40 feet high. And you give me a perception check. Oh, your nature check was an 18. Oh, it was a 14. Yes, you do know that those there, they are harmless, even though you notice something weird about whereabouts Moondancer is.
So we going down the cliff then?
Yeah, is that a sheer drop or is it like slope?
It's a 10-foot drop.
So the sheer drop then?
Yes.
For you, it's Mount Everest.
It's very far down for Zarian.
Notice a lot of noise coming from that room. Animal noise. Yes.
But I don't see anything.
Well, you see right in front of you a carpet of blackness on the ceiling. As it is covered in bats.
No, those are mushrooms.
I can do it at 10 minutes. I can talk to you.
Oh, well, that doesn't help.
We want to wait 10 minutes while I just try to... Egg, speak to me, egg! What do your 8 eyes see? Hundreds of eyes.
Do I... Can I tell...
Can you tell them?
I can't, like, they don't seem to be evil bats, do they? Can I tell them? Between evil bats
and like the bats!
From where you're standing, they're bats.
Is this the bat cave?
Oh, jeez.
It's not the bat cave, but it's the bat room.
Ah, okay.
I feel that's
just gonna jump down. Do I need to make an athletics?
Yes!
Boom! Plus
and
6!
You land on your feet with
perfect.
A bit of a sound, but...
Zarian's going to do it the smart way.
Oh.
He's just going to go on the hands and knees and use his hands. So he's basically... with how tall he is, he can basically just use his hands and get to the bottom and still be hanging on top of the ledge.
You would have to be looking at the creature, Lana.
Okay. Can I not see the bats?
No, from there, no. The bats start about there.
I'm gonna drop down in front of Alana. Just out of nowhere. And chitter to her. A simple concept. That it's just bats. That's what I want to try and convey to her. Bats.
He just keeps flailing all of his limbs in a bat formation.
All that you understand is food there. Jiomi understands your basic
what about, like,
food needs.
Flying food? Can Chili's get that? Flying food?
Sure.
flying foot there. And I'm gonna take off again. Actually, I'm gonna stand next to Smug and kind of like lower myself to see if he'll get on my back.
I got 50 feet.
Zarian's just like has his hands all the way up so he can just pick up, or so Smog can basically just glue onto his arms so he can just drop him down.
Yeah, that sounds better than getting on a spider's back.
because like my arms go over 10 feet high if I reach all the way up, so.
Yes, but you need to give me an athletics check if you're going down.
Yeah.
Sure, you managed to get down. This is just 10 foot, yeah.
I'm 7 foot tall for Pete's sake.
Yeah, it's easy for you.
And then I'll pick up Smog because he's basically a paperweight.
I'm pretty sure we how Kaelin and Buster are gonna get down.
Well, yeah, I'm gonna just try to
somersault.
Yeah. I'll help her if she doesn't do it at the same time as Smog getting down.
Sure, if you're gonna help her, she easily gets down. I'm just wondering how you guys are going to do for a 400-pound bear.
I thought they had climbing skill.
Yeah, he has climbing speed. Yeah, he can easily climb down. Yeah, I forgot. Yeah, that's climbing.
Like, I'm sure me helping it probably would still help, but...
What path are you guys taking? The left one or the right one?
Left one, because it's right there.
Yeah, I'm the right one.
I thought you guys were taking the right one.
I'm going this way. I saw the way the spider went, so I'm just gonna follow the spider.
Well, I'm on the roof again. I'm on the roof.
He's on the roof again.
I can still see him. I got dark vision.
Well, yeah, he can still see it.
Okay, true enough.
So you guys easily make to about where Aggie is.
I'm gonna just extend one spindly leg towards the bats.
And we see the bats.
Give me a nature check.
Smog. Oh god.
There you go.
Yeah, damn, you pick up all the good ones. The ones that are ripe and everything, you pick them up.
But he knows exactly what it is. It's fresh, it's not poisonous.
Yeah, he's just like, oh, this is for Novello, this is for Genie.
Did you say they were glowing?
No.
Oh. For some reason, I'm like glowing.
Yeah, how the hell would glowing mushroom be good for you?
That's what I'm saying, I was just like,
You never know.
What?
Never know.
Yeah, you see the spider pointing up forward, but you see the bats.
And the bats.
Oh, bats are good eats. Should we hunt for a minute? Quite hungry.
You do see how many they are, right?
Oh, I'm so hungry.
You just ate.
Shut up! I'm always hungry.
Yeah, I've noticed.
Can I do a perception check, like, in this area? Just to make sure there aren't, like, traps or weird stuff going on underneath the bats?
Underneath the bats? You mean above the bats?
Are the bats on the ground?
They're upside down.
On the ceiling.
I'm underneath. I'm looking for traps on the ground.
Upside down bats.
Yeah. Yes, you can.
I'm like trying to figure out a reason why the bats are just all right there. I don't know.
No, it's like the whole cavern in front of you is carpet. The ceiling, it's all bats. But you can give me a perception check.
Oh, Jesus. Oh, nice. I'm too busy scared about the bats, I guess. I don't know. Too worried.
Looking through the ceiling instead of looking at the floor.
I go into that and get on the wall instead, and just move along the wall.
I'm gonna be. Can I prepare an action to duck underneath all the horde of bats?
How are you guys moving? Normally or carefully, stealthily?
Sure.
I'm gonna be a little slow.
Semi stealthily.
I guess there's a horde.
Moving carefully than stealthily.
Yeah.
Because. Yeah, I guess I'm pretty still.
You are, but...
But I'm also glowing ball of light. With glowing ball.
Yes, and as you walk into the room, suddenly the whole ceiling just falls down. Just everything's black now with bats flying around everywhere. You can barely see around you all as we are all rolling for initiative.
Oh god.
I think those types of bats.
As you feel from between the bats, something starts trying to bite you.
Oh. Oh, the teams was. Oh, it did come up. Never mind.
I have blind sight as well, so I didn't see it. Tell what's around me. I don't know if they saw me against the wall, though, with that stealth roll.
The stealth roll was for startling the bats.
Oh, everybody else startled me.
As. I need to grab stuff.
Don't hit the back key and now I can't. Oh, no, I can't see things. I just have to find us.
Just keep rolling, man. You might as well get up to like 30 of
It's just a few.
It's just like the rats, man. There was only like two of them and they ate us alive. mostly egg.
There was just a few of them.
Have you stung
beetles? Run!
And they got the drop on everybody, so.
I have danger sense. No,
that's
I don't
for,
get scared.
Traps.
No, and surprise attacks and spells. And spells.
He doesn't say anything about surprise attacks.
I tried, man. Shut up. I did say duck earlier. I mean.
Sure, you ducked. You quacked. As 5, 10. 15,
20, 25, 30,
35.
Oh my god.
And.
Oh, I thought you were counting how many.
Hang on,
he's inside me. I'm
just. Shwack. As this. Ugh. I can roll the one in both of them.
Nice.
Oh, Sturges.
Yes.
Lovely. Yeah, what do we see? Where's our picture? Where's our neat little picture?
Is your neat little picture? I'll give you a neat little picture.
Jeez, it's like playing with Bob again.
I love the immersion. I like seeing the kobolds and the dragon and the drake.
But they're beautiful. Look.
These look a thousand times
better. Yeah! Oh, that's so cool.
Those giant mosquitoes
you
talked about,
yeah,
from
my like,
homeland?
Yeah. No. your mosquitoes are worse.
Oh, wow. So cool. I love these pictures. The artwork is really good.
40.
40 of them?
Wow.
Mez?
40 of them.
Okay. Well, I definitely see this one. I mean, if I don't see more than that. He's within 10 feet.
That one goes there. Oh god, this is so slow. That one easily moves there.
Jeez.
That'll miss. Barely.
Lucky enough that it misses. They can't roll.
That's good.
They have plus fives. They have to just roll okay.
So, since they're small and swarms, I can stand on top of them, right? I mean, like, I thought I went over there. That's what I'm saying.
You can stand on the same spot as them, yeah, but okay. Please don't. Because I won't be able to grab them. That one's for you, Spider Egg. Ooh.
Jeez.
I want to give people as much advantage as possible. I'm going to stand on one. I'm sorry.
And
I'll,
you have,
I'll move me if it need be.
You have this creature attached to you, Egg.
Oh, wow.
Ugh, not this again.
So I'll move this one out of the way. You probably lose sight of it, but it's attached to you. I'll give you a neat little thing. As there, you're bleeding.
Just saying, this is about to be funny on my turn.
Oh god, no. 5, 10, 15, 20, 25. That one's yours, Smog.
Nope.
14 for 5?
Nope.
First attack at you, and it actually misses.
Yep.
There's a lot. That one.
I think I might have lagged out. I don't see any more movement or rolls.
Because it's the same thing over and over again.
Yeah, basically, yeah, it's the same thing over and over again. That's the last one. That one goes there. And again, for Egg, 15.
Connection to server's been interrupted.
No.
Oh, there it goes. There it goes. Right. I got it.
Does that hit Egg?
Yeah.
And it's attached to you as well.
Fall to the ground. Hopefully I smash one while I fall.
You are in the wall. How high were you?
I was on the wall, so I don't know, halfway up.
Can you not stand there?
I can't see again. I don't know.
No, you can. Oh, you or can you not see my aura?
No, that's what I'm saying.
Oh, because you're back at Yogg, not Egg.
Yeah, but I thought the light was on Therian.
Because you're Yogg, not Egg.
No, yeah, just because I didn't have you with sight. Now you should see.
There we go.
You've fallen 10 feet, which means you take...
I'm gonna pivot so I land on top of these sturges.
You take 1 bludgeoning damage. And since there are 2... You smash 1 of them for 1 damage as well.
400 pounds and 1 damage?
Right, smash a wing.
That's fine.
Or you almost killed one.
Just the tip.
This
as tip. We go to Kaelin! Finally, you get to go!
Not much I can do against these.
Well, you can sort of see them sometimes in between the bats. As long as you aim an arrow, you should be able to hit. Probably. Maybe.
You'll hit something.
Really.
Gulad will be happy whichever way.
Hit Gulad.
Yeah, I'll remember that one.
Sure.
You'll have to put me into the order as well. Cause...
Oh, right.
Wow.
Yeah.
Excellent. Which one did you hit?
The dead one.
Wow.
What was your roll, Egg?
I think it was
let's see if I can find it.
12.
Yeah,
12.
12. 12. And descending. There we go. That's really bad. That one clearly is gone. It's pinged to the other side of the cave. I take it that's your turn then?
There's one underneath me, I don't, just so you know.
Oh yeah! That's the one you smashed. Just so you know. That one is gonna try and attack Zarin again. 24 for 4. And that's attached to you.
So since he transformed, is it still attached to him?
Yeah.
Oh, we didn't have the thing on, so.
Let me just do this.
It was luck, just somehow was luckily in my arm.
Egg away, and attach that one. God damn it. Really hate this being that slow. Actually, it should be blue. Before I actually lose track on which one's attached to who.
When did egg get two attached to them?
Egg got two attached to them.
Did they?
Yeah. You got hit twice.
Oh, yeah, sorry.
Right. That one gets to go. Is gonna go for Zarin as well, which misses. Smog!
Right, I need.
Thunder wave all of them.
I need. I need a thunder. I need a 10-foot sphere.
You need a 10-foot sphere?
Yeah, so do you count that as 10-foot sphere? Like from the center point?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah?
Let me grab a sphere. That's... No, 10-foot sphere is that.
That's 5-foot.
Yeah, 5-foot.
Oh, yeah.
Is
it?
Yeah. It needs to be 2 spaces from the center point.
That.
That's worse.
No, it's more.
Right, centered on him. Oh, hold on. Him.
Yeah, do that one.
Hang on.
Come on.
Doesn't need to be 10 feet.
Right, centered on him.
Yes. Would I hit all 4 of them? Well, can I hit all 4 of them?
Well, can you see it touching 4 of them?
Yes.
There you go.
Right, well, guess what? First level 2 spell. Zarian, cover your ears.
what'd you say?
You're gonna shatter.
Yeah.
Wow.
Excellent.
Holy hell, that's maximum damage.
No, it's not.
It's not.
24 is maximum damage.
Holy hell.
Also, where is it?
32 is maximum.
Oh, it's a 10-foot radius. Isn't that?
That's,
yeah, the radius.
It's a circle, so of course it would be a radius.
Radius. Radius. Yeah.
It's even bigger.
Oh, really?
That's why I've been doing this 10-foot thing.
Yeah, brilliant.
I thought it was just a 10-foot circle.
Well, there you go then. It'll be hitting.
So you'll hit
there. No, it won't be centered on him then. It'll be centered.
Yeah.
That's fine. You'll get rid of all of his.
If he's centered.
You might be able to do it.
On that one?
You could do it. There. No, because that would still not hit that one.
If it hits on that one. And it gets all 5.
Yeah, you can hit 5.
5! Con DC 15 saving throws, please.
I think they're automatically dead.
Half damage, if not, which is.
Okay, so they're all dead.
Yeah.
Yes,
eight.
They're all dead.
Nice.
And that'll also affect any loose stalagmites or stuff like that.
Yeah, the problem is the sound rings through the cave.
I think you just alerted every single thing in this cave.
We'll deal with.
It'll be fine.
As the sound rings through the cave.
I think killed all the bats in the area too.
They killed all the bats in the area, yes. There's food for the other one.
Gula has plenty of food now.
Definitely.
Our mage pulled through. I have Moondancer eat one of these on me.
Huh?
You do notice as the fungi starts to move as well.
The what starts to move?
The fungi.
What the hell?
The fungi? Where's the fungi?
On the fungus.
The fungi.
He wouldn't notice that?
He noticed something. They noticed something about it, but they didn't notice what.
He got a nat 20 on the fungus.
Well,
nat 20
on the fungus.
He did. Yes.
He did.
But the fungus has something that makes him undistinguishably, if he doesn't move.
Oh, jeez.
Wow.
How did that happen? What? They don't get to go. It's a -4. They're fungus.
-5 dex.
Jeez.
I will show to everybody. That's why. Sending and back to smog. That's why you can't tell if they don't move. Well, they are moving now. that's your turn, smog?
Yes.
There you go, Moon Dancer.
So, I take it these other bats are still alive then?
Yes.
Right.
Sturges, and there's still a load of bats moving.
It's gonna attack the one that's on Zarian. Oh, hold on, I've lost my thing.
The red one.
Yeah, the red one. Ba 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 ba. Nope, clearly not.
Yep.
I guess they're there. Let's fly by.
It's weird how she can fly through the wave of the cloud of bats.
You just hit bats?
Yeah.
This whole area is just all dead bats.
Wait, so these guys get to go before us? They get in an initiative right now?
No, he didn't, you didn't organize the list.
I did.
He did.
Did he?
Yeah.
9,
seven,
and then
three.
A 3,
oh,
1.
Oh, no, never mind. Yeah.
Then it made us 4.
Fungus is really for me?
No. Oh, that one fungus, yeah.
Yeah, that one, yeah.
That one.
That Sturge deals 6 damage to you, Egg.
Alright.
As it's draining your blood. That one's not attached, is it? No. It's not. That one's next to Smog, which...
Oh, hell's bells.
8 damage to you, Smog.
Yeah, that'll hurt.
And guess what?
Go away.
It's attached to you.
Alright, you know, go away.
Buster!
So, Buster still got one attached to Smoke, so he wants to run up and take a swipe at it.
That's gonna go well.
Oh, please, 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 please.
If you roll a 1, you're gonna hit Smoke.
You won't roll a 1, it's fine.
It's fine,
don't.
It's never gonna happen.
Oh no. Oh god.
Wow.
That's 8 damage on Smog.
Fucking hell.
Alright.
Swipe Smog in the face.
Can you tell your bird to piss off?
Egg. You can't spend your action to detach it, by the way.
Mm-hmm.
You have 2 attached to you, don't forget there's one under you.
There's one under you.
Yes.
Surely that won't be pinned then as well. If he's
well, when I say under, it's under the token.
Aye, but if he fell on him anyway, so.
It was on his arm. One on the arm and one on the
oh,
leg.
Oh, right, never mind. Fine!
I cast a
Just don't.
I'm gonna cast Moonbeam on myself.
What the hell does that do?
Let's find out.
Exactly. I know. Ghostly flames.
I don't think haunting you is probably a good idea.
Yeah, because you're going to take damage as well.
That's okay. I don't like things on my skin.
Alright. That one is the one under you.
Well, yeah, I didn't pass, so that's 9 damage to me.
Hang on. No. You didn't start your turn there. You already... on your turn, so it doesn't count as done for you.
Oh.
That one needs to make a constitution saving throw.
No, it's, oh, enters.
For it fails, so it takes your 9 damage. Which, let me grab it.
And then okay. Walk through the other ones.
Dies.
Well, I can move it, but it wouldn't move with me. I would have to move it.
Yeah.
And funny. Now it's the fungus.
The fun guys.
The fun guys.
What about the other one that's on me? You're just gonna wait for his turn?
Yeah, whenever it gets to his turn.
Okay.
That fungus moves there. And that's it. Sorry.
I'm going to grab my dagger. Like, grab it and, like, try to cut it off me. A 7?
No.
Oh.
I don't think so. then I am going to... Oof. I'll stay where I am.
Alright. Go on!
I did a self-wisdom check to see if I would even think that fungus could attack. I failed, so I'm just gonna move up.
Okay.
I'm gonna move up to the middle of the pack here, so you get advantage on all bats in this area. And I'm just gonna swing on, probably the one attacking Smog.
Oh, pass off.
I forgot it's on him. I'd probably attack the one on Eggman. I wouldn't want to smash the little guy.
I don't know if you want to enter 5 feet of me right now.
Well, he can still attack that area, though he's fine.
I mean, if he I'm a boss.
Steps into the light, he's gonna get hit, so he needs to do at least a constitution save.
Well, no, because it's 5 feet.
5 feet, so it's
he's still
square
outside. Yeah, he's still outside your area. He's just hitting the thing inside of it.
His weapon's 5 feet long.
Yeah, it's a 5 feet range.
His reach is 5 feet.
Yeah.
Alright, his hands aren't going. Fine with me.
It's usually it's a bit weird, but it is like arm plus weapon.
I mean, I got +4 to Constitution.
And you
still nailed it.
Still
so, I mean,
but no, you would be,
I don't care
you'd be able to reach and you'd kill it.
Okay, good. I mean, with a crit, you can be +1 on the crit.
That fungus
oh,
gets to go. It goes there.
It's so creepy.
That one gets to go. It goes there.
Did they make like a squeaking sound? Like
it's more like, it's more like a puff. That one moves there. Oh, and he is going to attack you, Kaelin. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Wow.
None of them hit.
Rolls.
And that's his turn. Kaelin, you have a mushroom next to you. It's not quite a mushroom. Let me see if I have a picture for it. I do have a picture for it. There you go.
Oh, that's cool. With skulls all around it. We didn't notice the skulls.
There was no sound in this drawing.
Violet, like violent.
Wow.
It's racist.
Wow.
Racist? For violent?
Maybe.
It's Galen.
Slash at it with the sword.
Do it.
Nice
hits. 9 damage. You hack part of it off, but it's still alive. That's where he gets to go. It's gonna deal 7 damage to you, Zarin.
Okay.
Smog.
If this is attached to me, I can just grab it and cast a spell, can't I? Yes.
No, you can use your action to detach it.
So I can't hit it if it's on me with the spell?
It's basically a mosquito, you know, right? It's just attached.
You can hit it, but even if it's on you and you miss horribly with the spell, you'll hit yourself.
Well...
And everybody's gonna point and laugh.
We're all gonna laugh at you!
Here. Crispy. Crispy.
That misses.
Oh well. Worth a try.
We can't hit these stupid things.
Everybody can see like Smog running in a circle trying to aim at that thing on his back and then suddenly casts a fireball that misses. Mundasa gets to go.
Guess where she's going.
This is going to be fun.
Well.
Be positive at this, she can't kill you.
Well.
Also misses.
Oh, and they always hit these things, for Pete's sake.
But that thing's going to deal 4 damage to you, Smog.
Oh, damn it. Oh, I really am worse for wear looking.
Is that... That's the second time it hits you, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
It created the first time, right?
Yeah. Yes.
So that thing, after sucking your blood...
It explodes.
No, it detaches itself from you.
Good.
Buster!
Well, Buster's seen Killing getting attacked there, so he wants to charge down and swipe at the...
At the fun guy?
Yep.
That misses.
Silly bar.
Wait, misses? No,
yep.
That hits.
No.
That hits and that kills it. He's used to seeing fungi. Egg.
Now I'll see my constitution.
And also, you should. You don't have any of them.
Isn't there one under him?
No, that's one.
No,
the one that died for the moonbeam.
I would get out of that moonbeam.
Banana salad.
Yep.
There we go.
You're fine, you take half damage.
What was the damage? 9? Was it 9 before? So
yeah,
yeah.
9.
4?
5.
5?
4 or 5, yeah.
Oh, you round up, never mind.
Alright, I'm gonna move that sucker, and it's gonna... the path is gonna take it through this guy.
You can move it? Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
It's like a weird spiritual weapon.
Yeah, I'm gonna move it onto this dude, but yeah, it'll hit that guy on my way past.
Yeah, you will. What does it say? Whenever a creature... See, it doesn't say whenever it passes through. It says whenever a creature enters, which is weird wording if you can move it.
Well, technically you would be entering it.
No, I'm still going to consider the creature entering it, but it should be worded better. Still considering the creature enters, which it's a constitution saving throw. Makes it.
Oh.
5 damage.
Still dead.
Nice.
Can I have my blood back, please? I want my blood back.
Although, that violent fungus doesn't make it. Takes 9 damage. And is that your turn?
Man, I should have moved it through all of them, shouldn't I?
How far can you move it?
What is it? I can move it.
1 mile.
60 feet.
120?
60. And I moved it.
25.
Yeah, so I'll just keep moving it until it hits the last one.
Yeah. Two more then.
Nice.
One makes it, which is the last one. So that one takes 9 damage. And that one takes 5 damage.
Mm-hmm.
There you go. You're gonna move or you're gonna stay there?
No, I will be staying right here.
Alright, so that one gets to go, and he needs to make another constitution saving throw, and he fails, taking 9 damage.
Dead.
And he is gonna move.
Next time I should just move it in a circle over and over again.
Basically, yeah.
Back and forth.
Zarian!
Wait, he's not dead?
Who, Zarian? No.
No, the one you just moved.
No.
It took.
One of them died with 11.
It took 14.
Well,
yeah.
Twice, right?
Yeah, so.
Okay.
The super shroom.
It's the super shroom. It's the one up shroom.
Oh, man. Somebody
that. Zion. He's patting the storage.
Just get it off of you and I'll crush it!
Hello, Zarian.
Nope. He's gonna try and stab it.
I'm gonna try to cut it again.
Yeah, that hits. And that also stabs it. Kills it.
Here, you can crush it if you want.
I'll eat it later.
I will undervise it.
Oh, God. Gulad.
Well, I guess seeing that everything is dead over here. I've always hated mushrooms. I'm gonna move 5, 10, 15, 20 feet. I'm just gonna get in the middle of all of them and I'm gonna smash this one. This first one right here.
Alright.
Just trying to give everybody advantage on him. Oh, yeah.
Yeah, he's dead. That one gets to go, and he's gonna go for you, of course.
with.
Wow, minus one.
Get out of here!
Minus one to hit.
Does that mean I get to smash it as a free attack?
No. Galen! Oh, God.
With advantage.
Yeah, if she's going for the short swords, yes.
Yeah.
That kills. Then. Smog.
Oh.
He's still trying to recover.
He was like slowly like limp to there. And he's gonna cast Firebolt at the one he can see. Well, the only one left.
Oh, Firebolt. He said Fireball for a second. Overkill.
Overkill.
And that smokes it.
Smoke falls flat on his back.
As we are out of initiative for now.
I look at Smog, but I still pick up all the mushrooms. Like, you need these things, do you think?
Nope.
I want to make sure bats, it might not be too bad.
Okay,
is it no, we can't eat them?
I think this is a good place for us to stop for this week.
Yeah.
Okay. Does anybody have a decent amount of cure wounds?
Before we end, I was going to...
yeah, if you guys want to heal and stuff before we end.
I was going to do one. Put down my unicorn.
Holy hell.
Oh, jeez.
I don't even think I need to do that anymore, but, you know. So I'll put down my unicorn, and,
Spirit of him. At second level, you do a lot of things.
Everybody gets 11.
Everybody gets 11 hit points then?
Nice.
So 11 hit points back.
Ah.
I feel perfectly fine.
I feel better.
Even had to waste any spells.
Let me take off your red dot. Do you wanna heal yourself, Smog?
I did.
Just healed him. I healed all of it.
I'll use a cure wound.
You just did.
Smog.
You're still missing HP from me.
Yes.
If we take a quick rest, you can use this hit dice, right? Instead of using more spells.
He's fine.
Thank you. What's my max?
I didn't know if we were going to be afforded the opportunity. You didn't. Somebody made a lot of noise with a certain spell.
Ryan just did it.
Yeah. Hang on.
13 hit points for Smog.
Yep, thank you.
Why are you showing me?
Just worried about spell slots when there's more cave to be explored.
Don't worry, yeah.
Oh,
I got plenty.
Right, there we go. There we go. Gulad's HP bar was a bit broken.
Mm. Yeah, I know, it was at 22 and I just popped it up.
Yeah, somehow it was not tracking your HP correctly.
Yeah, I don't know why.
Probably broke itself whenever updated thingy. Yeah, you guys can spend all of your spell slots, I don't mind.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like, I was like,
you guys are.
We can rest. You don't need to. Too late.
You're barely right. Into the cave.
I've used one of my spell slots. I think I'm fine.
I've already used two. MRI two. Well, for now.
I haven't used any of my important stuff.
Kaelin there. And put Buster near Kaelin.
And I got Moondancer under.
Gulon near Buster.
Egg goes away.
Egg goes with all his family.
I should add.
I hope you guys had fun tonight.
Yep.
I had loads of fun.
I was
fun.
Just afraid we're going to fight anything. Huh. Glad we got to smash something.
You guys got your third level, so stuff's getting interesting.
We're leveling up without even having to kill anything.
Well, to be fair, last time you guys didn't even level up. On the last week?
Yeah, so close.
Yeah. You guys were really, really close. It was literally just escape, and that's it. Next week is the week you're not here, right?
Yeah, I'll be London, or I'll be home, but I'll not be on. I'll be too tired. More probably.
That's fair enough, no problem. So there won't be a session then next week.
Okay.
All right. So just so you guys know, well, Johnny had said that before.
Oh, ages ago.
Yeah, ages ago, just to remind
that
there's that also means to anybody watching my stream, there's not going to be Heart of Dragon Queen next week, so be sure to check the schedule to know what's going to happen that day. Might be something weird, most likely. Anyways, I'm gonna head down here to end my stream. Guys.
Yeah, I'm gonna jump too.
Sounds
good. Alright, folks, that's another D&D session over in Domus. Level 3, nice one. Couple extra spells, yeah, them two spells I got, wow, they're gonna be awesome. So, to anybody that called in Shadow the Dragon, thank you so much for calling in. I will get chatting to you shortly, probably in your own stream. And to everybody else that's still hanging about, thank you so much for calling in. If you have enjoyed the stream, please do hit the follow button. I very much appreciate it. Tomorrow night, there will be another stream. There will be A Way Out, half past midnight UK time. To anybody that's here for D&D, there won't be anything on next Thursday night. I I'm away on holiday and just I'm going to take a nice wee relaxing break, but I will be streaming again come next Friday and tomorrow night. More than likely we'll be streaming something on the weekend as well, so do check out Twitter, which is the same handle as this, and not only can you find me there and on here, you can find me on YouTube, which there is some previous videos of Horde of the Dragon Queen up there, so if you want to go and check that out, definitely do. It's just getting more and more interesting as we go, so thank you guys once again for calling in, and I will hopefully see you all again next time, so cheers and good luck.